Hello everyone, my name is Mark Robinson. This is Leo Schlenker, day 11 of the Australian Open. We're getting down to the business end. Leo, the men's side, Federer, Nadal, Djokovic is on right now, and the one who's broken out from the pack, the Frenchman.
Yeah, for Wilfried Tsonga, a very exciting player, Robbo. He's just come through the section that Andy Murray should have come through, and he's had a history of beating a big-name player and then just falling away. He's held his nerve this time, and he's into his first semi-final. A really tough one for him. Doesn't get much tougher than Rafael Nadal tomorrow night.
What about Djokovic? He's playing as we speak right now, so check on the website later and you'll get the final scores of that match. He's braining him.
He's flying at the moment. He's up against a very tough competitor, David Ferrer, and if he gets through him in straight sets, puts him in really good shape to play the winner of Roger Federer or James Blake, who play tonight.
Has Blake got a chance?
No.
No. Righto. Let's get on. How are the women situated at the moment?
Well, Robert, it's amazing. You watched a lot of the Williams matches over the past couple of days. How's that all gone down?
Well, I'll tell you what, it's been a wipeout the last 24 hours for the Williams sisters, both out in the singles, and they got beaten in the doubles yesterday. Mark Stevens, who you've been watching on this on the website in the last couple of days, accused Serena of being ungracious yesterday. Venus came in for a press conference about a half an hour ago. She was a lot more gracious than her sister. She was asked if the Williams sisters, and let's be honest, I mean, how many women are left from America who are really challenging, it's the Williams sisters, and she was asked if they are they still a major player in women's tennis, and she reckons they are. Your thoughts?
They definitely are, Robbo. I mean, Serena came here as defending champion. She's lost that. Venus is the reigning Wimbledon champion. They've both bombed out. Haven't been really bad losses, but you're right with Serena. The way that she reacted to her loss after losing to Djokovic was pretty ordinary.
It was ordinary, actually. She didn't even pass on any congratulations to her opponent. Like today, first thing Venus said was, she was far too good for me.
Yeah, Ivanovic cleaned her up, and that's the way they are. I mean, they've been great champions. You wonder how much is left. They've had a lot of injuries, a lot of distractions in their career. I wouldn't write them off yet, but things are certainly changing.
Maria Sharapova, we saw her last night. She's in devastating form. To beat Justine Henin, Justine Henin, as she did. I mean, she's a very tough player, Justine, and Sharapova just minced her.
She did, and a lot of controversy off the court too, Robbo.
Well, Leo, you're a long-standing News Limited tennis writer. You've been around for, I suppose, the ugly parent syndrome. You've seen a lot of it from Mary Pierce all the way through. Yuri Sharapova last night was caught by TV cameras sort of gesturing across his throat. Now, you can look at that in a couple of ways. Kevin Sheedy did it in football in AFL and was really lambasted. But you've written a comment piece which will be appearing in tomorrow's paper, so buy that, have a read of it. But just give us a bit of a thought of what you thought.
Well, I believe he's been asked today to explain his actions by the WTA, the Sony Ericsson WTA Tour. And he has explained it away by saying, this gesture meant it's all over, as in the movie director's cut.
Which is arguable that he could have done that.
There is, Robert, but I think there's a more sinister overtone. And we've seen him before. He's got himself in a lot of trouble over the years. Maria Sharapova has been on the circuit for 6 years. It's only next month she's playing her first match for Russia in Fed Cup, and that's because none of the other Russian players wanted her or her father anywhere near them. He is a bad egg.
What about his... Oh, well, let's not get us to talk about his dress sense, but especially me, but what do you think about his hooded garb he was wearing on centre court last night?
Maria likes to call him the assassin. I think he's playing up to that a bit, and I think intimidation is a big factor in what she does with the screeching and also his on-court presence. We saw 2 years ago, Robbo, with... He called out Vamos, Spanish, come on, in the match against Denon, and then turn around and there's no one behind him in the courts. That was ridiculous, and so was his stuff last night.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, be back here tomorrow about the same time. We've got a sensational 24 hours of tennis ahead, and then we're heading into the women's final on Saturday, and of course the men's final on Sunday. Talk to you soon.